What do people say you look like?
Ryan Seacrest.
You did homework? We're not even paying you.
Welcome back to Idol Hangover. I'm joined by Taylor Hicks, Season 5, American Idol winner. Taylor, thanks for coming back and
thanks,
hanging
Shirley.
With us. Okay, so we want to talk to you about what's going on. You've got a Vegas show. Let me first ask you, tell us about the show.
I was offered 2 months at Bally's this summer. And, you know, being that I'm working on a record, I'm working on a country record right now, it just really made sense. And to be a part of that history and the culture of Las Vegas, and considering full circle that I auditioned
in Las Vegas
for American Idol, it just the perfect. I mean, what person would not want to go and work in Las Vegas for a summer?
Oh, that's.
I mean,
great.
Whether I was like a pool guy or something, I'd probably want to, you know, go hang.
And, I don't know. It's hot out there, man.
Yeah, that's what they tell me. See, yeah. I mean, I'm used to like, you know, southern humidity, mm-hmm. but like this like dry sauna deal that they got going. But it's, you know, they said that, you know, that it's a busy time of year. Conventions are there. And, you know, I think it's just a great look for me. And it's the, you know, when you get to do something for the first time and your contemporaries, you know, you get ahead of the pack, so to speak, being the first idol to do it. It makes a lot of sense. And right now where I am in my career, it's just a perfect gig.
Absolutely.
I'm very blessed.
Oh, good. Well, I mean, I'm curious. How do you do Vegas? What's your Vegas?
I think a lot of it is, obviously benchmark songs from American Idol and, songs off, you know, my records, songs, the cover songs that are great, and then, you know, classic Vegas show tunes.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, add a few rhinestones in the costumes, and you have a great act, you know, and hopefully that can... you know, translate. And not only that, but interestingly enough, you know, to for the idol thing, you know, Rod Stewart's in Vegas the same time I am, and you know, I'm gonna throw a backpack on and go sit in with everybody on the strip, you know. So that's kind of a, from a cross promotional angle, it's just awesome, because I know Celine Dion's bus driver was my bus driver.
Oh my God.
For a long time. And I mean, like, when we're talking like in like when Celine would do her own hair and makeup every night in the bus back there working it. You know, I total fully utmost respect for her as an artist and entertainer, and I'm just really thrilled to see some, and probably sit in with Holly Madison, whatever she's doing.
Excellent. So it'll be like Taylor Hicks' greatest hits, basically.
Yeah, basically.
Oh,
yeah.
I love that. I feel like we should get an encore of In the Ghetto to get the Elvis thing. You know, the Elvis theme going?
I was thinking about, you know, songs from the show, because, you know, having this, you know, Phillips being the top two in the finale, I mean, it's awesome to see that there is that interest in the organic music and the true artistry, and I think it's, you know, good timing for him to be in the finale, for me to be doing a Vegas show, and I mean, I think obviously doing songs off of American Idol will, you know, we'll translate.
Absolutely. So what about games? Like, what's your favorite game there? Are you gambling?
I've done so many. I do a lot of casinos. And single deck blackjack is my favorite, because mm-hmm. I feel like it's like the game where it like makes you think that you can count the cards, because there's only, what, 54 in a deck?
Right.
So, you know, when you like play with like four friends, like you think you can count the cards, and you're thinking that you can count the cards. So... that's what I love to do, is like, oh, there's already 10 kings out or something, you know, and you have this idea that you're, you know, beating the system when you really don't.
Right. But the cool thing about that is, like, you just have to follow the rules. I mean, that's the beauty of blackjack. You know the rules, you can play it. But do they even have single deck blackjack anymore? Is it all those, like, machines?
I'm hoping that they do. If not, then I'm going to learn craps. But... luckily, I've gotten to the point to where casinos are like office mentality,
mm-hmm.
as opposed to like the first time, like a couple of times I played a casino, like I went and cashed a check, and then it, from playing that night,
uh-huh.
and then
it was gone. Uh-huh.
So like the first two gigs out of the gate were, you know, were not smart.
Right.
And so I learned my lesson kind of early on with, you know, so you have to be careful. But I do want to go to like, you know, because I've go you go through there, you know, and you only stay like 24 hours and then you leave. Like, I'm gonna go to like all the like clubs, and I'm gonna turn into a club kid too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Awesome.
I mean, that's kind of like, it'll be nice to stay there and be able to experience all of it. Because, I mean, we went to Vegas on Idol to see Barry Manilow when Barry was a mentor. And we actually snuck out, all of us, and went to like, and got in the front of the line and went to the club without anybody knowing. And, you know, just because we're, you know, of drinking age, of consumption age. And so I'm looking forward to it. I'm blessed to see what that has to offer.
Excellent. When does it start?
June 26th. You Excellent. Can go to bally's.com for info and tickets.
Great. And of course, you know, I'm going to be there. I want to cover it.
Please.
I'm going to. I'd Great. Actually kind of like to try to make the first show. Or is that not good to go because you're not warmed up yet?
I would get the, you know, the wheel needs the grease a little bit.
Okay.
A week into it would
okay.
be perfect.
So we have a date a week into your Bally's gig.
And we'll turn into club kids afterwards.
That's right. We're going to go see Swedish House Mafia. do you have a favorite Vegas movie? Like The Hangover?
Yeah, I was thinking about that. I was mm-hmm. thinking about what could you do to like, you know, and I thought that like during the encore, everybody could leave the theater and go outside, and I can throw a mattress off of the, you know,
there you go,
off of the roof, and Wilson Phillips could, you know, be my backup singers.
Excellent, excellent. Yeah, that's a good one. I liked Hangover too. Also, it was funny shit. Okay, so let me talk to you about your music, because you moved to Nashville.
Yeah.
And you're going to put out a country record. Tell me, where did this come from? Is this something you've always wanted to do, or did it make sense?
I think after, you know, really touring for 6 years and really, you know, understanding who your audience is, because, you know, in the beginning, you know, after the Idol win, I mean, you know, you have the Idol fans, and then you have to turn them into Taylor Hicks fans, mm-hmm. you know, and there's an interesting, you know, you have to, like, bring those fans along with you. And, you know, after doing that for as many times as I had and performing, doing the Broadway thing, and I think ultimately, you know, my fans listen to country music. That's what they listen to. I'm more of a song, I'm a really song-driven musician, and I'm also, you know, a roots-oriented, and I played in as many roadhouses and honky-tonks as you can imagine in the South. And growing up with country songwriters, it just makes sense, you know, a Southern soulful country record for me would not be far from what I did on my last record. Mm-hmm. Or to a certain degree, you know, just from a production quality standpoint, something that I did on my debut album, mm-hmm. After Idol.
Right.
So it just makes complete sense that's, and you know, I play country blues harmonica, and I've gotten to know a lot of the artists and played on some country bills, and it's just, it's where I need to be. It's song-driven, it's rootsy and country and Southern, and that's me.
Excellent. And Nashville is a very supportive musical community, right? I mean, does it feel, did you feel at home right when you got there?
I did, and I lived there 10 years ago, mm-hmm. and trying to make it, you know, as an artist, and that was tough.
Yeah,
you know?
Sure.
And so now coming back and being able to, you know, experience all the musicians there, and if you make a record there, you don't have to fly anyone in and out. It's literally, you go down the street into their house, downstairs, you meet their wife, mm-hmm. you meet the kids, you write a record, and then you go home,
uh-huh.
and then you go to the studio. They come from 15 minutes away, and you know, you have this, it's a really cool, you know, community, and it's not easy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm gonna have to write hit songs. This point in my career, there's no room for error. Period.
Got it. Wow.
So it all has to be hit songs, and I can't release it until I know down deep inside that this is a song that all of those Elvis fans on Idol that are listening to country music will go, oh, I get it. There he is.
That's awesome. Timetable?
I'm hoping. Just depending on the labels aspect and the shopping and the release time and stuff, when it's ready. I don't have a timetable. Everybody wants me to, you know, always strong arming you about when are you gonna have it, when are you gonna
right.
have it out. But this particular part, you know, I'm already 35 years old.
Right.
You know, I'm not 16. I'm, So what's the difference between 35 and 36? Maybe 5 gray hairs?
I was just going to say, you got the gray already.
I mean, yeah, I was 35 when I was 15, so I understand this mentality, you know. When it's ready, I think ultimately I've got a couple of songs that I know that could translate well to that I've demoed, and I'm just still learning to be a recording artist. As in Philip and Jessica and some of the, you know, all the contestants, you know, a lot of them really didn't spend all of their time in a studio. So I think you have a hard line when you win American Idol. You ultimately, everybody expects you to be this world-renowned recording artist.
Right.
And there's a huge difference in learning recording music than just performing it on a stage.
Right. Especially when it's your own music.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, one last thing we wanted to ask you about is the other project you're involved with, The Choice. This is a dating show, like a speed dating competition show.
It was such a big, it was just one big blur. One big dating blur.
How did you get involved? Did this come through Fox?
It came through Fox.
Okay.
They called me and they said, "Are you single?" And I was like, "What?"
What a weird question.
I've got Mike Dornell on the phone and he's asking me if I'm single. Wait a minute. What is the deal here?
Mike, I know you're married and
Mike,
you have children.
Yeah, Mike, you're married, you have children, and you're asking me if I'm single. What's the deal? And he explained to me the format of the show, and I said, yes, I was single. And he said, well, do you want to be on this brand new dating show we have this summer? And I was like, well, yes. Yes, I would like to be, you know? And I think the format of the show is brilliant. I mean, the love connection, the dating game, the voice, everything that you can think of from a dating perspective that's been on television in the last decade and cross-pollinated with the, you know, the idea of that you're going to, you know, do the voice angle too. And it's,
which is so ballsy. I mean, I gotta hand it to them.
To a certain degree from a trademark standpoint, I was very like, you know, like, how do they navigate the waters in this deal? And it navigated. And this ship has sailed, and it makes for great television.
Now, but it's not like The Bachelor where you're, like, expected to propose at the end, right? This is just like you're going to go on a date, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. There's no marriage. And there's no
rings. No full commitment.
No rings. No. We had such a great time. You get to actually, you know, meet the girls and... you know, you go out on the date and you have a good time and you know, it was super fun. And I mean, the format, and I got to enjoy, you know, when I got to enjoy other male celebrities, Warren Sapp and The Situation. And I talked to The Situation after he does laundry every afternoon, you know, basically, you know, GTL. And I was like, I told him, I was like, man, you know, why would you, you know, so you've gotten past your third season of television. You made all this money. Why are you still doing laundry?
I know, right?
Well, he's that way. He's real. And that's so funny. I had such a great time with all of the guys on the show. They're all really sweet guys. And we there was some really great chemistry and some great TV moments.
And is it all guys who are choosing
girls? The guys are choosing the girls. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, you know, the girls choose the guys and then the guys choose the girls.
Oh, gotcha.
So it's mix and match.
Oh,
and
very nice.
Then, you know, obviously there'll be 4 celebrity ladies that do it too. So it's 4 celebrity men, 4 celebrity ladies. And it's I think it'll be a great show.
Summer viewing, I love it.
Summer loving.
Summer loving on The Choice with Taylor Hicks. Well, let me just ask you one last thing, which we would never ask on Idol Hangover, but why the hell not, since we're talking about dating. What is the perfect romantic night for you?
Oh, I think I like to drive out to different places. So I don't like to, like, drive up and then, you know, and then there the restaurant be or something. Like, I like to, like, almost make it kind of like destination dates.
Oh, destination dates.
So it's like, you know, anywhere within, like, a, you know, 20 to 30 mile radius. Like,
out
so you
to
get
Malibu
the car,
or...
Yeah, you get in the car, you drive, you get to know that person, and then you, you know, I think it's...
Oh, I love that.
But, you know, it also puts pressure on you not to get too terribly drunk, too, because you got to drive. So
that's true.
It's like, you know, there's always a method to the madness here, but...
That's almost good. That's like an order of protection.
Keeps you grounded.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I think, you know, I think ultimately having fun and, you know, I entertain for a living, so it's nice to be entertained back, whether it be food or you know, jokes or, you know, and I obviously, like, I enjoy
good conversation.
Yeah. And being real and down to earth, you know, and, you know, you can, you know, this is like, I'm just enjoying, you know, I enjoy like the, kind of like the dark Italian restaurant in the middle of nowhere.
Mm.
You know?
Oh, that sounds great.
And the Soul Patroller two seats down.
Excellent. Oh, Taylor. All right, well, I'm going to wrap up this interview, but Dee Dee is the final phase of your Idol Hangover
interview.
I'm
so excited.
Dee Dee Benami is going to come and ask you Twitter questions from your fans, of which they have plenty. So I'm going to sign off. Taylor, thanks again.
Thank you. Thanks, Shirley.
Hey, everybody. So we are back with Idol Hangover with Taylor Hicks, and we have some Twitter questions. So thank you all for tweeting them in. Taylor, our first question comes from Peg. What is the funniest interaction you've had with a fan? And what's the most unusual gift that a fan gave you?
Funniest interaction with a fan. I think what's funny is there's been a fan of somebody else that thinks you're that person. That's the funniest interaction that I've had, is like someone that thinks you're another person when you're really not.
And who did you think you were?
Actually, George Clooney.
Really?
Somebody was like, these two people were actually like in completely, you know, I mean, what was even funnier about it is that my friend like played along. Uh-huh. They came over and they said, you know, we don't mean to bother, but we've always wanted a picture with George. If you don't mind, please, you know, and actually we played along with it, and, you know, I talked and they left, and then I completely died laughing. I mean, we just hit the floor. And those kind of interactions are funny. The real interactions from a fan, from fan to fan, I mean, when they say that they're related to you, those are always interesting.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Where your cousin, your new brother pops up.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's when the shit gets really crazy. You know?
And you're actually like...
And then, not only that, but they tell you what time that you're going to meet them for lunch tomorrow, because they're having a family get-together and you're invited, and, you know, they put pressure on you. I mean, basically, probably just like they do their real brothers and sisters, which you aren't one of. So that's, you know, I've had to actually, you know, and even funny enough, they were like, see, we have the same hair color. Like, you know, like, this is, I mean, from a gene perspective, like, this is exactly, I mean, couldn't be a better fit. I mean, you know.
We'll see at lunch tomorrow. Does it happen often?
A few times. You know, right after the Idol thing, when, you know, I mean, you would be surprised how many people go into their genealogy and try to figure out if you're real. I mean, people that really have a lot of time on their hands, which to a certain degree is a television viewing audience, and you know, very social media savvy one as well, like Idol fans are, and they will go into their whole, you know, complex, and you'll get that on the road, you know. Mm-hmm. And I guess my season was just super huge, so I had this, you know, interesting, you know, dialogue between some of my long lost brothers and sisters.
I love that. All right, next question is from Tish. Taylor, will you tour the new album right after the Bally's residency is finished?
Depending on if the album is ready or not. That's what I would say. You know, I've got to make sure that the music's great, and hopefully, you know, I will be touring, and, you know, hopefully with a new record soon.
So, just in addition to this, since we were talking about it, can you talk about really quickly the pressures of putting out an album after American Idol and getting music out, and how, as an artist, coming from an artist standpoint, like, what it's like and how scary it is, or if it's not, how did you feel when
I mean, if you think your work is, you know, if you think, you know, you're off TV and your work is done, you know, I remember Clive going to a Clive Davis party. I think it was it the City of Hope Gala or something? It was the City of Hope Gala. Mm-hmm. And I think it was maybe 4 days after I won. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm completely exhausted and like a zombie by this point. And so, you know, we do this big, you know, big show, and then, you know, I come up to Clive, who's basically my new boss, and Clive goes, "What the hell are you in the studio?" You know, like, this, you know, I'm thinking to myself, like, oh, did my boss just tell me to go to work right now? You know, like, I've got to, you know. So you got to do a record. And you have to make a record that basically is going to, you know, eclipse all the other Idol winners, going to sell 25 million copies, and you're going to be, you know, then you will get your, you know, you need to be up there. But it, you know, I mean, that's the pressure of it. So it's not easy.
Straight from the mouth of Taylor Hicks. Next question is from AG at Sweet Smoke One. Does Taylor have any acting plans after his gig in Vegas is up, or does he hope his 2-month stint there will be extended?
You always want to have more work.
Mm-hmm.
I think, you know, if the show goes well, and which I'm hoping it will, and I think, you know, if it is extended, you know, if it, the ball's rolling, then you don't do anything to mess it up, you know. So I think yes, with the right, you know, with hopefully the show will be extended, and you know, we'll see what happens from there. But acting classes, you know, I've been taking a few, and I love them. You know, it's interesting. Acting is really just acting acting, you know, out actions and stuff. Music is basically acting words.
Mm-hmm.
So there's been an easy transition for me. So yes, I am pursuing that. But it's an interesting thing, you know. Just because you win American Idol, you have to find the right role, and people have to believe you. You know, so the producers and people around here in these offices want to know if you've been pursuing acting. So
right.
It's important.
Right. I feel you. All right. This next question is from Jennifer Jacobs. Jennifer asks, can you give us a hint on how your Vegas show will be different from your concerts that you've had on the road, you've been out doing?
Well, I think you can incorporate some rhinestones.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's going to be as many as I wore in Greece, but I think that might be half, which will be 6,000 as opposed to 13.
Nice.
So the idea, it will be flashy, obviously, and but also classic. I don't want to get away from, you know, the idea that it's not the classic Vegas show too, because
yeah.
I think people will like that, the spin of a, you know, a classic Vegas show. So I'm excited about it.
Well, you are in Vegas. It makes sense. You know, gotta
yeah.
do it up. Gonna go. All right, our last question is from AG, Sweet Smoke One. Please ask Taylor if his new CD will be released on a major label or independently, and thank you.
I think the great answer to this is the right label. That's, and whether it is a major or whether it's an independent or whether it's my own label, I think ultimately the right label is, you know, I'm excited about, I'm kind of like itching to get back in the label game mm-hmm. a little bit. So I'm excited, you know, about the prospect of them being all, but I'm, you know, it could be a major, or it could be an independent. It just depends.
What do you think would fit you more? I mean, are you?
Well, I think from a country record standpoint, I think, you know, obviously, you know, you know, there are pros and cons with every one of them. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, the majors have the pull, and but also there's, you know, 50 artists on their roster.
Right.
You know, and right now you need, you know, from you want a boutique perspective, you can go with an independent.
Right.
So we'll see. Sorry to not answer it.
Well, you answered one of his other questions earlier, so
good.
It's fine.
Good.
We appreciate you tweeting your questions in. Taylor, thank you so much for
Thanks,
coming
Didi.
In, answering
Love your
questions.
Single.
Thank you.
Heard it last night.
Thank you, Taylor. Yes, I do have a new single out. Yay! It's called Gasoline. Check it out. I love this. And thank you all for tweeting your questions in and for keeping up with us this season at Idol Hangover. We love you guys and have an awesome year. Take care.
What do people say you look like?
Ryan Seacrest.
You did homework.